Welcome to the project demonstration of IoT smart water quality monitoring system. There is a reconfigurable, nothing but we are going to monitor the pH and the turbidity and temperature of water quality continuously through the Wi-Fi technology and into our mobile phone. So means we are going to continuously stream this data, the pH, turbidity in NTU and temperature in degree centigrade. These three parameters continuously streaming to our mobile phone, and if is there any abnormal condition detected, like temperature is high, turbidity is high, then automatically we will get the message alert into this, as well as the buzzer will be indicated here. So here the whole system controlled by the our Raspberry Pi Zero or W, that is our inbuilt wireless one. And here we are making use of Arduino UNO. Why? Because so these three sensors are providing us the analog output. So nothing but 0 to 5 volts variable voltage. But a Raspberry Pi generally it will read only digital or serial or I2C or SPI. So the analog data can't be read by this Raspberry Pi Zero W. So that's why we are making use of Arduino UNO. So it will read this analog data from these sensors and it will convert that into the serial. It means analog to serial conversion purpose, we are making use of this, and the particular data will be given to this or Raspberry Pi Zero W. So coming to this connections and boards, so here we are using LCD display, will display the data continuously on this 16:2 screen display. And next we are using of these are the drivers for the turbidity sensor, and this one is a breadboard in order to distribute the 5 volts power supply throughout this board. And next buzzer board. So here we are, there will be one transistor, means the system will switch on this transistor and the transistor will switch on the buzzer. So before switching on this switch, we need to install one application, two applications in your phone. So right, so go to the Play Store and type Juice SSH, one application, and a Network Analyzer. This is the Network Analyzer app. Okay, so one application is a Juice SSH and a Network Analyzer app. So after installing these two, next go to your hotspot settings. So here change your hotspot name to Project 4373, all are small letters without any capital letter, and password is 123456789. Check two times and then after on the hotspot, and then switch on the switch. So once we switch on the switch, there will be a welcome message on the screen after booting was done, and then right, the buzzer will be on and off two times. And now go to Network Analyzer app. So you can check the hotspot settings also. There one device is connected, right? And now Network Analyzer app, go to the options and LAN scan and do the scan. So there will get the two. So one is your mobile phone, and another is 192.168.239.47. And now Juice SSH, and now go to the manage connections and click on add button, and here three settings will be there. One is cell, the type is going to be the telnet, address is which we get from the Network Analyzer app, that is 192.168.239.47. So it's very important, check 2 to 3 times clearly, and then port number 8080. So one is telnet, address, and port number, and after that add, and now check on this. So now three lines will be there, and after that the pH value, temperature in degree centigrade, and turbidity values continuously streaming to your mobile phone. And now once the same data is appearing on the LCD screen also, just I'm placing this in a water bottle, and you should dip this probes into the water bottle till end of this, right, like this. And we can check the after some time these sensors will be stabilized and we'll get the pH data will be increased. Okay, you should mount it properly, right? We can see the right. Okay, and coming to this turbidity, so just pour the water on the glass, in the glass, and place this, right? So we can check the turbidity also. It will also slightly will be decreased, and right now it will be increased. So based on the transparency, that will be nothing much. And coming to this temperature, so if we increase the temperature, whenever it crosses the 50 degrees centigrade, so we can observe on this same on LCD also, when it crosses the 50 degrees centigrade, then automatically the buzzer will be on. Right, okay. And also high temperature message will be sent to your mobile phone through the Wi-Fi technology. Right, thank you.